got a sponsorship deal from South Korea. Then I went to do my internship in South Korea for 1 year.
I thank God that I went to university that at least created a platform for people to venture into business.
It is true. We have been in business for over 20 years now, empowering Kenyans to own ideal and genuine properties. And yes, the biggest and the best urban residential development in Kiambu, Amani Ridge, the place of peace, is taking shape. Let us show you what we have been up to. The Solomonic Gate is complete. The intelligent fountain of peace is up and running. The stone perimeter wall is complete, fully enhanced with razor wire for your security. The 100,000 liter capacity water tank is coming up. We also have the house designs and the title deeds for every plot. Invest in value. Call us today on 0790 300 300 or visit us at www.optiven.co.ke.
Je, maumivu ya kichwa na kukosesha amani? Kaluma Strong utuliza maumivu ya kichwa, maumivu ya mwili na hata uondoa joto jingi mwilini. Kaluma Strong ina aspirin kama kiungo. Maumivu ya kizidi, muone daktari.
This is NTV.
And welcome to NTV Weekend Edition. We start the broadcast, as always, with the global coronavirus numbers. And there are over 18,000 infections worldwide, and the global death toll is at 690,000. On the continent, there are 951,000 infections and over 20,000 deaths. Meanwhile, in the United States, the figures stand at 4.7 million people infected and over 158,000 deaths. Kenya's numbers in a moment, but first, these are the day's top stories.
Tonight, Kenya's COVID-19 caseload tops 22,000. And there's a new problem. Frontline medical workers have demands.
We'll bring this country to her knees on Monday, the 10th of August 2020, if these issues are not addressed.
Also tonight, former IEBC Commissioner Roslyn Akombe nudges ex-CEO Ezra Chiloba, and it's all about the mysterious murder of ICT manager Chris Msando. Plus, of strangers living side by side.
It had its own reason, which now Tanzania of course reacted, but the push towards nationalism is affecting international relations globally.
Kenya and Tanzania's incessant spats threatening regional stability. And they lost their daughter and were awarded compensation. But more than a decade later, still no money.
I took a judgment to take insurance, Amago insurance. Wakangalia, wakaniambia ningoje for 2 months, nikaenda.
A family's painful pursuit of elusive justice.
This is Weekend Edition with Smriti Vidyarthi.
Thanks so much for joining us. Flora Atieno is our sign language interpreter, and I should correct that there are over 18 million infections worldwide, not 18,000. Now, it is yet another grim day in the country as the coronavirus caseload has topped the 22,000 mark. 690 more people have tested positive for the disease in the last 24 hours, raising the cumulative count to 22,053. The new infection numbers have been confirmed from a sample size of 5,393. 681 of the new patients are Kenyans and 9 are foreigners. 58 individuals have been discharged from hospitals, bringing the total number of full recoveries to 8,477. Another 5 patients, though, have died from the disease, and the death toll is now at 369. Well, Nairobi County still carries the biggest share of new infections, with 535 reported cases. Kiambu County has recorded 56 new infections, Kajiado 28, Nyeri 24, and Busia 9. Machakos has 7 new infections, Kisumu and Nakuru have 6 each, Embu and Garissa have recorded 4 new cases each. Well, as the number of coronavirus infections keeps soaring, yet another challenge is in the offing. The Kenya National Union of Nurses now says it will rally its members to a nationwide strike effective August 10th if the government fails to meet its end of the bargain on compensation and protection of frontline medical workers. And as our health reporter Eunice Omolo now tells us, a strike may make an already bad situation much worse.
The Kenya National Union of Nurses is accusing the government of failing to hold its end of the bargain by not paying risk and other allowances to its members. And in the face of the health crisis presently before the world, Secretary General Seth Panyako says the nurses deserve more for being on the front lines.
The Senate should put in mind that nurses are demanding a risk allowance of Kenya shillings 20,000 to be introduced in their pay slips permanently. That we together with our all health workers and other county public servants will bring this country to her knees on Monday, the 10th of August 2020, if these issues are not addressed.
But that's not all. The Kenya Medical Association says medical practitioners deserve a proper insurance policy for its staff, as well as prompt compensation in the event that one contracts or dies from the virus. So far, over 500 medical workers in different cadres have tested positive for the coronavirus and a number of them dead.
The issue of compensation and insurance in case a doctor or a nurse or the other key workers actually lose their life while providing service. You know, just the other day we lost one of our colleagues, and you see these children that you are leaving behind, the family and those dependents, we need to have a robust insurance scheme to actually protect the healthcare workers in case of demise in the line of duty. And this is something that has been implemented in the other essential workers. I know in the army, in the police force, this is done. And I think it's time we really sit down and implement that for the healthcare workers so that we can have, we go working knowing that you're giving our all for our country. But in case, in an unfortunate case, we lose our lives, then we are able, we know that the people we have left behind, then will be taken care of by the government.
We demand with immediate effect the reinstatement of National Health Insurance Comprehensive Civil Servant Medical Scheme that we have been told it has been stopped.
The Kenya Medical Association also says safety and remuneration concerns are affecting the productivity of medics.
It affected the morale of healthcare workers because you are there serving the public, but you're not able to actually take care of your family back at home. And in instances where some counties are lacking quality PPEs, then you have to procure them, and they're very expensive for you as to protect yourself and protect your family. So I think we're going to have a meeting with the different stakeholders and the government, Council of Governors, to ensure that these workers who are actually our frontline soldiers are well taken care of.
There is no denying that a strike at this time will paralyze operations in public medical facilities already reeling from the soaring number of infections. Eunice Omolo, NTV.
Elsewhere, it has been close to 3 years since the brutal murder of former ICT manager at the Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission, Chris Msando, just days into the 2017 general elections. As authorities dig through the evidence in search of the perpetrators, attention is now shifting to the commission. Former Commissioner Roselyn Akombe now claims that her push for an inquest into the death was thwarted by then-CEO Ezra Chiloba. But as Zainab Ismail reports, this is not the first time Akombe is stirring up the waters.
In a social media post early on Sunday, former IBC Commissioner Roselyn Akombe sparked a heated conversation online with a tweet of an email on the gruesome murder of ex-ICT manager Chris Msando, which she claims came from the commission's former chief executive officer, Ezra Chiloba. On 29th July, I said I will testify at an independent judicial inquest into the murder of my colleague Chris. I received this email from Ezra Chiloba, former CEO IBC Kenya, writes Akombe. To which she claims Chiloba responded, and I quote, "Dear Roselyn, do not attempt to rewrite history. Our silence is not your license. Yours, Ezra." This is not the first time the former commissioner has pointed back to her former employer in the murder mystery.
We'll be available to the public.
Msando's body was found in a thicket at Muguga Forest in Kikuyu 3 years ago, the post-mortem indicating he was tortured before being killed. 3 years later, still no answers on exactly what transpired. In the heat of the 2017 electoral push and pull, Akombe fled to the U.S. 8 days before the October 26th repeat presidential poll, from where she announced her resignation from IEBC. She claimed her life was in danger.
I've been agonizing for months now about my role at the commission and my effectiveness at the commission and my safety, actually, and security.
NTV reached out to Chiloba for a response, but he declined to comment. The commission is also yet to respond to the claims by Dr. Akombe. But the commission's troubles extend beyond the murder mystery. The acrimonious resignation of top commissioners left the electoral body without quorum at a time when planning for the next general election should be beginning. Then there is a possible referendum should the Building Bridges Initiative push for amendments to the supreme law. Zainab Ismail, NTV.
Now, resumption of international flights in Kenya on Saturday suffered the drawback of the decision by Tanzania to bar Kenya Airways from landing on its soil. As Kenya and Tanzania move to resolve their latest dispute over the reopening of the skies, following the COVID-19 shock, pundits are now asking the two countries to find an urgent and permanent solution to the long-standing spat. Victor Kiprop reports.
When a Kenyan delegation destined for the farewell service of former Tanzanian President Benjamin Mkapa last week was turned back mid-air, both governments attempted to downplay the incident, with one side blaming a technical hitch on the plane and the other blaming bad weather. But Tanzania's decision to ban Kenya's national flag carrier Kenya Airways from flying into the country in reciprocation of what it said was Tanzanians being banned from entering Kenya was enough evidence that all was not well between Nairobi and Dar es Salaam.
These are countries belong to the same East African community. They are countries which have a long history together. And so we would have expected better relations, better understanding. And for me, this is where now we need to fix our diplomacy. Both Tanzania and Kenya needs to work on this so that these frictions do not keep to be recurring.
In recent years, the two countries have been squabbling over different issues, including testing of COVID-19 at the borders, implementation of regional trade policies and border community disputes, and not even a personal visit by President Uhuru Kenyatta, in which he was gifted 4 peacocks by President Magufuli, would mend the strained relations. The resurgence of nationalism is one of the reasons cited.
In diplomacy, nothing happens without a reason. So Kenya had its own reason, which now Tanzania, of course, reacted. But the push towards nationalism is affecting international relations globally, and Tanzania and Kenya are no exception.
Being two of the largest economies in the region, sibling rivalry has also been cited as a potential catalyst to the tiff, as well as the difference in political ideologies.
Magufuli, who was so much aligned to ODM leader, Raila Odinga, took leadership in Tanzania. Uhuru Kenyatta took leadership in Kenya. And these are regimes which had different ideologies.
On Saturday, Kenya's transport ministry said Kenya had not banned flights from Tanzania or any other country, and the two countries had already resolved the dispute.
That advisory which was given by Tanzania Civil Aviation Authority yesterday, we believe by end of the day, to be reversed.
The East African Business Council has called on countries in the region to fast-track unconditional reopening of regional air transport services in order to spur intra-regional trade and revive the tourism and hospitality sectors which have been hardest hit by the coronavirus pandemic. Victor Kiprop, NTV.
Efforts to forestall another fallout in the Senate over the disputed division of revenue formula have been stepped up with numerous meetings and extensive lobbying among leaders across the divide. The Senate's Majority Chief Whip has convened a meeting for Monday morning, understood to be a final push for support ahead of Tuesday's vote. Our senior political affairs reporter Kennedy Murethi has more on the intrigues playing out behind the scenes.
NTV has learned that Majority Whip Irungu Kang'ata has been gagged from speaking to the media on the intrigue surrounding the motion on the revenue sharing formula days after issuing threats of a possible end to the handshake if leaders allied to Raila Odinga voted against it. Kang'ata has also reportedly called a virtual meeting Monday morning to lobby for support and evaluate the gains ahead of a fresh vote on the formula on Tuesday. A Sunday afternoon meeting at the home of COTU Secretary General Francis Atwoli waded into the dispute, and it is understood Senate Minority Whip James Orengo brought the team up to speed with the latest. Jubilee Party Vice Chairperson David Murathe is understood to have represented President Uhuru Kenyatta, and according to sources, talks are ongoing and a deal may be reached late Monday. Atwoli declined to speak on the matter when NTV reached out, only saying the revenue formula and BBI were discussed. Insiders say Raila is disturbed by how opponents and mostly those allied to Deputy President William Ruto have been painting him in the debate. Some have accused the ODM leader of fueling the dispute in the view that his support bases will lose in their locations.
Raila is trying to play politics.
Correct.
He is trying to play safe.
Correct.
He knows he does not want his people to support the committee's report.
Correct.
And the best way for him now to come out, because he has seen that this has put a strain on his handshake and purported cooperation with the Jubilee Party.
Yes.
So he's now brought a strange formula that has not been brought to the floor of the House.
Yes.
Talking about that is the direction to go. I can tell you for a fact, for Nakuru, we have been losing about almost 500 million if I went with the CRA formula.
Hii siku ya formula kupita. Yeye aliandika kwa katika magazeti ati amesema formula ipite. Na hiyo siku akaandikia watu yake message. Akawaambia ikipita wewe umepoteza kiti. Kwa hivyo Raila tumejua wewe sio rafiki yetu.
Raila had last Tuesday called on the Senate to adopt the proposals by the Commission for Revenue Allocation before amendment if there was no solution to the impasse.
Hii maneno ya ugawaji wa pesa wa nichi inaenda inaingia mpaka BBI. Na tunajua handshake ilikuwa mheshimiwa rais na mheshimiwa Raila Odinga. Kwa hivyo ningependelea tuwaachie watatue hii neno.
Another round of voting will be held Tuesday, with last week having set the ground for those for and those against.
Kuna hiyo equalization fund article 204, hiyo tutapea makaunti ambazo ziko na zile marginalized, kama zile za Northeastern, kama zile za Coast, kama zile za Turkana, kuna kitu inaitwa equalization fund. And as a counties who come from region, wenye wamesema wameendelea, sisi tutaendelea tu na equitable sharing revenue. Na ndio maana watu wengi wamekuwa wakimisquat some of us when we say one man, one vote, one shilling. It is a matter of principle of equity, fairness in allocation of resources to counties.
A vote on the floor on whether to postpone implementation of the formula by the committee for two financial years if passed by the House was shot down, with 25 senators voting against it, while 22 supported it.
It is possible, from where I sit, to have
a win-win formula. A win-lose formula is not a solution.
It is this close vote that the proponents of the motion are banking on, with spirited lobbying and political pressure. Kennedy Muredi, NTV.
All right, from those divisions to a united front, it's time for a breather on NTV Weekend Edition and have a look at these few good united men. This group of 10 locals living on a remote island in eastern Indonesia rushed and struggled to push a stranded short-finned pilot whale back into the sea. Eventually, though, they did manage to rescue the marine mammal, which swam off itself. But sadly, 10 other whales of a similar type were found dead with cuts, likely caused by the creatures coming into contact with sharp rocks. Stay with us.
Oh, yani aje, miro jonte fresh. Mi ndio nimetambulika hii Gikomba yote sekta ya manguo.
Jumio transform nguo dinare za mtush. Zenye ziuka mna hii harufu ya bale into the freshest hii Gikos yote.
Siri ni hii Ariel mpya ya pink.
Na kushua mtush zinangara kungara kushinda kamera. So clean, so fresh. Ma customer unai sana na history. Ninatumia Ariel touch of downy mpya tu.
It is true. We have been in business for over 20 years now, empowering Kenyans to own ideal and genuine properties. And yes, the biggest and the best urban residential development in Kiambu, Amani Ridge, the place of peace, is taking shape. Let us show you what we have been up to. The Solomonic Gate is complete. The intelligent fountain of peace is up and running. The stone perimeter wall is complete, fully enhanced with razor wire for your security. The 100,000 liter capacity water tank is coming up. We also have the house designs and the title deeds for every plot. Invest in value. Call us today on 0790 300 300 or visit us at www.optiven.co.ke.
Sensitivity pain fast with Sensodyne Rapid Action for clinically proven relief in 60 seconds.
Mambo mengine sio rahisi, lakini kupata 50% extra airtime ya kukona kwa SMS ya Safaricom mambo ni one touch.
Pata 50% extra credo bila expiry ya kupiga na ku SMS across networks. Piga *444* scratch card pin hash. Na kama ni M-Pesa *444*2# Safaricom for you.
Did you know there's a laundry bar soap that can help save you time, water and money? Try Whitewash Extra, the 3-in-1 soap, detergent and softener. Its unique formula provides a quick and effective wash, softens fabrics, and is gentle on your hands too. So you save by not having to use multiple products. And you only rinse once. For a laundry soap that can help save you time, water, and money, try Whitewash Extra. Brand power, helping you buy better.
In this house,
yeah.
My money,
yeah.
Is uh-huh. ours. But pesa yako,
mm.
your family yako.
Do you think that was an issue? Do you understand where I was coming from?
various institutions have reported over 800 million units of unclaimed shares, among other assets. To find out if you are an owner or beneficiary, dial *361# or visit www.ufaa.go.ke.
Welcome back to NTV Weekend Edition. The row between the Teachers Service Commission and the Kenya National Union of Teachers continues to simmer. NUT insists that its members are being discriminated against after they were denied promotions and salary increases for a second year. But TSC says the union made its bed and it must now lie in it. With more on the teachers' twist, here's Anita Nkonge.
It is a battle that has been running for over a year now, pitting the Teachers Service Commission on one hand and the Kenya National Union of Teachers on the other. In the middle are the men and women charged with the responsibility of imparting knowledge on our children. The bone of contention has been whether teachers should be promoted and their salaries raised under the TSC's career progression guidelines or the schemes of service which is preferred by KNUT. Having taken the battle to court, the court ruled on the 12th of July 2019 that each party would keep its respective approach. And so when TSC announced its annual review, thousands of teachers who fall under its career progression guidelines were promoted and their wallets were a bit fatter. But teachers who are members of KNUT missed out on their benefits. KNUT cried foul, but TSC says that it is this very decision that has left KNUT teachers locked out when it comes to promotions and other benefits.
The teachers who are serving under schemes of service have remained without a promotion because the court directed as much and because NUT went for it and it was given. The court is like the Bible, ask and you will be given.
But Wilson Sosion disagrees.
Part 12 of the collective bargaining agreement, and I quote, states very clearly that parties agree that career progression in the teaching service shall be implemented as provided under Part 6 of the Code of Regulation for Teachers, end quote. And we were very sane, we were sober when we were signing this agreement. Part 6 of the Code of Regulations therefore fully recognizes the schemes of services as tools to manage promotional progression of teachers. Nowhere does it mention career progression guidelines.
The TSC says it has filed an appeal in court.
As a responsible constitutional commission, we have obeyed what the court said. Until our appeal is heard, and we are still going to try to convince the Court of Appeal that what the High Court did was wrong. Allow all teachers to serve in the new career progression guidelines.
Furthermore, TSC denies claims that it is running two payrolls.
The allegations that there are two payrolls in TSC is a white lie. It is sweet because NUT will say, you see now us, because we have not been promoted, there are two payrolls for us and the rest. Wrong. There's only one payroll. The only difference is that some teachers are serving under career progression, others are serving under the schemes of service as per the court order.
Anita Nkonge, NTV.
And elsewhere, the government now says the fresh flare-up of violence in Nakuru County, which left five people dead and scores others injured, was a result of a misunderstanding. Rift Valley Regional Coordinator George Natembea says that several suspects are in police custody as focus turns to reconciliation efforts. Leila Mohammed with more.
An easy calm has returned in Marishoni area of Nakuru County days after a fresh flare-up of violence between two neighboring communities erupted here. In the end, five people were killed and scores other admitted with various injuries. The government says it is cracking the whip to restore peace and stability.
Tumewakamata watu 16 kutoka kwa jamii zote mbili. Wako kwa police station, wamehojiwa, wamerecord statement na watapelekwa kotini kesho kushtakiwa na makosa ya mada, mauaji ya kukusudia, arson, assault na kupromote warlike activities.
Among the persons of interest are political leaders.
And some of the people that we've arrested are politicians or individuals with political ambitions. And people who believe that for you to be a serious politician, you must make people fight.
Natembeya says the conflict was a result of a huge misunderstanding, which had nothing to do with inter-community relations.
Mzee na bibi yake walikuwa wanazozana. Mama akapigwa, akapiga nduru. Wengine wakasikia nduru, wakapiga nduru. Na nduru ikapigwa hivyo pa kila mahali ikakuwa ni nduru. Yale mambo ambayo ilikuwa mzozo wa kijamii ya familia moja ika spread, ikawa kwamba watu wamemobilize usiku kuamkia asubuhi ya Jumatano, watu wakaanza kuchomeana nyumba.
The regional commissioner says that 196 houses have been touched and thousands displaced in the process.
Hizi vita zili affect vijiji vingi sana, karibu vijiji 10.
The government is also planning a series of reconciliation meetings between the two communities. Leila Mohamed, NTV.
Now, local manufacturing is set to receive a significant boost if Parliament approves the tax procedures of unassembled motorcycles regulations 2020 bill. The proposed law, among other things, compels motorcycle manufacturers to source for parts locally in a phased approach. Here's Alex Mwangi with more on the potential future of the industry.
There is no lower hanging fruit in Africa today than production of motorcycles, because they are easily available and they have become part and parcel of what we do.
It seems that that has informed the latest move by government to raise the level of manufacturing with a bill seeking to promote local manufacturing of motorcycles. According to the proposals, motorcycle assemblers will be required to source these items locally 6 months from now, as they will be excluded from imports, forming part of the completely knocked down kits. The center or main stands, the crash guards, the handlebars, rear carriers and grip sets, the right third rider footrest or pillion set, the left third rider footrest or pillion rest, the side stand, kickstand and prop stand, and the battery liquid, acid or fluid.
There will be a lot in terms of foreign direct investors. They are going to run into the country because there is no investor who is worth their taste that is able to make a decision into investing in a country where there is no proper policy or guided legislation in terms of protecting their investment.
The constant and growing demand for motorcycles creates a safety zone for investors in the industry.
The Kenyan market has about 180,000 motorcycles per year. So this protects every investor because they are assured of those numbers immediately.
A further 7 items will be excluded from the completely knocked down kits after 12 months, giving local manufacturers the opportunity to provide them not only locally, but also for the East African community and beyond, if EAC talks to harmonize regulatory laws are fruitful.
We are now talking of 680,000 motorcycles market per year. And that positions Kenya and the EAC for the African market, because then Kenya and the EAC becomes a hub of production.
If the bill becomes law, the impact of the new regulations will cascade to the rest of the manufacturing supply chain. There are about 900,000 motorcycles in the country, with each boda-boda supporting 6 people, hence about 5.4 million Kenyans are supported by the industry. Alex Mwangi, NTV.
Right, we're about to take a break, but nation journalists across the country have dug up information on the companies retained to support the fight against the pandemic and have revealed interesting connections linking power and business. The investigative series takes you inside the entities that win government tenders and will eventually culminate in the launch of an open contracting portal as part of nation's new digital brand, nation.com. media.africa. The portal will support media story linkages, data storytelling, access to information for research, and extend the shelf life of procurement-related stories after the first publication. Tomorrow, the newspaper brings you details on the fight for COVID-19 billions by Afya House, the Kenya Medical Supplies Agencies, and the Kenya Bureau of Standards. We will lift the veil on the people behind coronavirus tenders in the coastal counties. So make sure you grab your copy of the Daily Nation. All right, there is plenty more on the other side of this break, but do stay tuned and have a look at Tokyo's new normal. Now, the coronavirus pandemic might have left many restaurants empty, but one establishment in Tokyo is relying on some model customers to enforce social distancing. Lifelike mannequins keeping diners from getting too close. They sit still in this Chinese restaurant, and you see a child there dressed up and also a lady in an ornate Chinese style dress. That is what it looks like in Tokyo. Stay with us.
Ati, neza taka kwa hii kabambe, nipate 4G smartphone.
We wacha, nani unasema bale ya kujikaza, ninaweza pata smartphone mpya na 20 bob peke yake daily.
Ati, badala hii tochi yangu neza nuno hiyo 4G smartphone niangaliange vitabu kwa mtandao. Nani 20 bob peke daily.
Pata smartphone mpya kuanzia 20 bob daily pekee ukilipa mdogo mdogo. Weka down payment ya 1000. Lipa kuanzia 20 bob daily kwa miezi 9. Piga star 544 hash kuona kama unafaulu kupata 4G Neon Ray Pro inayokuja na screen kubwa ya kutazama video, battery inayodumu, space mingi ya kuweka picha na videos, HD camera na apps zote za Google unazopenda.
Kuma bei ya smartphone hapa.
Kao bei ya smartphone.
Si hapo safari kwa muni yako kapiza.
Sona moja imetengenezwa kwa njia speciali ili kupambana na maumivu kwa haraka. Sona moja ina aspirin kama kiungo. Sona moja, kitulizo kamili. Maumivu ya kizidi, pata ushauri wa daktari.
For a better tomorrow, don't forget to do the 1-2-3 with Colgate every night.
You have worked so hard. Now your project is nearing completion. You now need to crown your labor. For over 50 years, East African Cables has been a premier manufacturer of high-quality electrical cables, manufactured to international standards for the region, giving you the reliability and safety you deserve. We manufacture an extensive range of power cables for applications in domestic and industrial wiring. Our work speaks for itself. Get in touch. Let's talk cables. Kumbuka, Wire C-Wire. East African Cables. Connecting lives.
Are you living a blessed life? Get this and more Christian music only on Angaza Music, Africa's first exclusive gospel service. In addition to music, get your best Bible stories, preachings and devotionals, church services, DJ mixes and more. Get Angaza Music for 10 shillings daily plus 50 MB data bundle. Dial star 544 hash, then select option 6 on your Safaricom line. Angaza Music, Baraka Mkononi.
Welcome back. Now, a family in Ongatarongai is still chasing justice a decade after a motor accident robbed them of their daughter. Years after being awarded compensation by the court, the family is yet to receive any money as a lack of convergence between the insurance company, the police, and the owner of the vehicle has stalled payment. And as Ruth Samway now reports, they may not be the first to fall prey to such.
A sense of grief is still palpable at the home of Eric and Caroline Opio over a decade since their six-year-old daughter died. Emma Akinyi was on her way home from school in June of 2009 when a construction truck veered off the road and knocked her off the walkway into the trenches of Ongata Rongai.
Gari ilikuwa ina overtake punda. Ikaacha punda, ikagonga mtoto. Mtoto waka anguka kwa mtaro. Kumbe venye alimugonga mtoto pia akaanguka vibaya. Akaumia kichwa.
Akinyi died 3 days later while receiving treatment. The family filed a suit with the guidance of a lawyer identified as Caroline Muhia. It was all smooth until it wasn't.
Ikafika wakati sasa, akanyamaza kabisa. Walifanya judgment kama tu kujua, judgment ilifanyika. Sasa hii mambo ya judgment tulikuwa tunasindilia. Judgment kwani haijafanyika? Judgment kwani haijafanyika mpaka anasema judgment ilisafanyika. Niendeni kajiado court. Muende mujitolee nini upewe huko.
But that would only add insult to injury.
The verdict was given in 2014 by the Kajiado Law Courts that this family should be compensated approximately 790,000 Kenya shillings. But since then, the lawyers and the insurance company have been taking them in circles.
Kwanza siku hiyo, tumejaribu, nikachukua judgment, nikapelekea insurance ya Amago Insurance. Wakangalia, wakaniambia ningoje for 2 months. Nikaenda wakaniambia gari haina insurance. Na kama wamelipa waseme wamelipa wapi. Juu sisi wenyewe hatujapata kitu. Tunaumia na tumeumia kama familia ya Emma Akinyi Opio. It's very painful nikisikia mambo ya hiyo mtoto naweza lia lakini najaribu ku cool down. Juu ni uchungu venye mtoto alikufa ICU Kenyatta, very painful.
Amaco Insurance absolved itself of blame, saying, and I quote, "We would like to reconfirm that the car with registration number KAC890D was not on cover at the time of the accident. The vehicle history in our system shows that the said car was on cover from May 2010 to May 2011, which is a year after the accident." The insurer further said the policy number stated on the police abstract belongs to another customer in our system. But OB records at Rongai Police Station, where the case was reported, confirmed that the vehicle was registered under Amaco Insurance Company as its policy number indicated. George Kithi, an advocate of the High Court, says oftentimes parties collude to cheat victims out of justice.
It's always a push and pull between those that should give and those shouldn't give. For instance, a person who has a judgment, the lawyer would want fees from that person and the insurance companies also would want as much as possible not to pay. But it could be also a process that has an element of connivance. For instance, the connivance between the insurance company and the court processes or even advocates who then represent their clients vis-a-vis the courts.
Kithi advises that according to court procedure, the judgment requires that compensation be paid by the owner of the vehicle. If the owner proves that his vehicle was insured at the time of the accident, the case should then be forwarded to the insurance regulatory authority for further investigation. If found to have flouted laid out guidelines, the insurer may be sanctioned. Ruth Sarmoy, NTV.
Well, may justice be served to that family. Now, the sense of sight is possibly the most delicate of senses, giving you the capability to see the world for what it is. But for one man, the sights, shapes and colours abruptly faded to black. Moses Nyongesa lost his visual ability in a flash and life has never been the same. Naoma Sampao brings us his story of devastation, but also determination.
With his first degree in hand at the age of 23, Moses Nyongesa's path was lit with opportunity. He set his sights on pursuing his dream, a career in engineering. And after 7 years of climbing the ranks, Moses was shining. He became a first assistant engineer in charge of design and construction at Kenya Power within the North Rift region. But one evening, with a blink of an eye, Moses' life was thrown into disarray. A car accident he was involved in while driving home from official duty in Lolongo robbed him of his vision.
I almost committed suicide because I guess it was strange. You are in a strange world because, you know, it's total darkness.
Through his work, he was the man that lit up people's lives and powered people's homes. But without his sense of sight, the father of two was left feeling powerless.
I couldn't believe because remember they used to bring homework for me to assist them their homework. Yes, so I do not understand how I was not able to do that. You feel very useless because you see, you've been my friend. Yes, now suddenly that I'm not the way I was. Suddenly you literally walk away, you see.
For months, he struggled to accept his fate, but determined to change his blurry mindset and be there for his children, Moses eventually gathered the courage to work towards a transformation. He sought clarity through enrolling for a 9-month training course at the Kenya Society for the Blind.
You're in a class of like people. Everybody is like you. So, you know, there's that kind of that synergy and the ability, the power to move, you know, the resolve to move forward.
Moses was supported by his organization, Kenya Power, which purchased the job access with speech software for him. With this, he sharpened his sense of hearing, which he now highly depends on. Moses is able to send reports, respond to customer queries and complaints, and has been involved in numerous projects, including the installation of CCTV cameras in Nairobi and Mombasa. He also bagged the company's Employee of the Year award in 2017. Through his journey, the once devastated engineer has come to realize that even in darkness, there is light.
A flick of the switch, and there is light. But it is not as easy for engineer Moses Nyongesa, who has been in darkness for over a decade. He may lack the sense of sight, but he lights up your home nonetheless. Nayoma Sampao, NTV.
A story of hope right there, Moses having transformed his life. Now do stay with us as we take another break on this broadcast. But first, one man in Germany can no longer brew his beer. Why? Well, it's all because of storks that decided to build their nest on the chimney of a Christian Zwanger's brewery. There you go. His beer production has stopped and his stocks are running low, but he does remain optimistic as a craftsman is expected to elevate that nest somehow. Storks are a protected species in Germany.
Ah, Helen Paul.
Hello, madam. Would you like to join us on this mission?
Yes, but how?
Just one question for you. How do you keep your toilet clean?
I use regular detergent and bleach for washing and removing yellow stains. I've been using it for years.
Oh, madam, the regular detergents and bleach are used for washing clothes. To disinfect your toilet properly, you need Harpic 10X. It is specially made for germs and stains removal. Harpic's thick formula settles on stains and gives 10 times better cleaning compared to regular detergents and bleach.
Wow, now I'm convinced, Helen Paul.
Really?
Yeah.
Now that she's part of the mission, the next house is yours.
John suffers from indigestion. His twin James suffers from heartburn. Sometimes it's the other way around or both. That's why they use Gaviscon Double Action. It soothes within 3 minutes and lasts up to 4 hours. For double relief from heartburn and indigestion, Gaviscon Double Action. If symptoms persist, seek medical advice.
Breaking news from Morphix. Let's see what they're developing right now.
Morphix pants with anatomic fit technology.
New Morphix fans, an invention from babies for babies.
You should also try Morphix.
Pata smartphone mpya kuanzia 20 bob daily pekee ukilipa mdogo mdogo. Weka down payment ya 1000. Lipa kuanzia 20 bob daily kwa miezi 9. Piga star 544 hash kuona kama unafaulu kupata 4G Neon Ray Pro. Si hapo safari kwa muni yako kabisa.
All right, welcome back. Some international news now. In South Africa, Africa's hardest hit country, has surpassed the 500,000 mark in coronavirus infections, with a total of 503,290 cases. This is after 10,107 new cases were announced by the country's Ministry of Health. The number of fatalities stands at 8,153. Well, the president has stated that the country's fatality rate stands at 1.6%, which he says is significantly lower than the global average. The country has become the epicenter of the deadly pandemic on the continent, accounting for more than half of Africa's diagnosed infections. More than a third of positive cases are in Gauteng province, which is South Africa's financial hub. And elsewhere, shaming the devil may have taken a new meaning as thousands of Muslims took to stoning the devil by throwing pebbles at a wall that symbolizes Satan. This is the last ritual of Hajj, which is the annual Muslim pilgrimage in Mecca to symbolically, quote, humiliate the devil. The ritual would normally be attended by millions of Muslim faithful, but this year only 10,000 took part. In line with the coronavirus preventative measures, the faithful were handed sterilized rocks by Hajj authorities to throw at the wall. They were also spaced apart by marked spots on the ground to ensure social distancing was adhered to. All right, the sports news is coming up in just a moment, but do take a look at this. Time-lapse images show storms rolling into Miami as Hurricane Isaias made its way to Florida's eastern coast. Isaias was packing maximum sustained winds of up to 136 kilometers an hour. It eventually dumped torrential rain on the Bahamas over the weekend as it then rumbled towards Florida, the first big test for the storm-prone U.S. state reeling from the coronavirus crisis.
Get up to 95% financing for old brand new vehicles payable within 60 months. What's more, you can access a Biashara Boost credit facility of up to 200,000 shillings and two free memberships for Maisha Cover from Amref Flying Doctors. Family Bank, with you for life.
Dovu flours are fortified with vitamins and minerals to provide wholesome goodness for the whole family. Dovu all-purpose flour makes the most delicious chapatis, mandazis and all other pastries. Dovu is readily available at your nearest shop. Dovu Tosha.
Get this and more Christian music only on Angaza Music. Get Angaza Music for 10 shillings daily plus 50 MB data bundle. Dial star 544 hash, then select option 6 on your Safaricom line. Angaza Music. Baraka Mkono.
It is true. We have been in business for over 20 years now, empowering Kenyans to own ideal and genuine properties. And yes, the biggest and the best urban residential development in Kiambu, Amani Ridge, the place of peace, is taking shape. Let us show you what we have been up to. The Solomonic Gate is complete. The Intelligent Fountain of Peace is up, and running. The stone perimeter wall is complete, fully enhanced with razor wire for your security. The 100,000-liter capacity water tank is coming up. We also have the house designs and the title deeds for every plot. Invest in value. Call us today on 0790-300-300 or visit us at www.optiven.co.ke.
Maajab, my friend, as you wait for the call, my friend, is it just perturbing how sure you are that the call is going to be picked? Maajab, the recipient is probably held up. In our days, we...
To get Baba Otis Maajabu by Flaco, dial *811*936#. Skiza, Nan Nation.
In this house, my money is ours. But pesa yako, ya familia yako. Mpaka imeka place, akita kamika kumifanyie. Kama nini, kanywele, kanitu vitu tu. Yeah. Hey, kuna avocado, kuna nini.
Inabidi unaitisha wisdom kutoka above. Na hapa inafaa unajipaka kama mwanaume.
Maybe na tukianza. Do you think that was an issue? Do you unafeel nikana kuonea ma? Do you understand where I was coming from?
Ay, topa di top. Topa di top. So unajitanga topa di top DJ mo. Kuwa topa hata kwa nyumba, fanya kila kitu. Misu unajiweza. What una complain?
Various institutions have reported over 800 million units of unclaimed shares among other assets. To find out if you are an owner or beneficiary, dial *361# or visit www.ufaa.go.ke.
Sports news now, and international left-back Dennis Odhiambo may be 35 years old, but he still has a dream. Odhiambo, who has featured for a number of Kenyan Premier League clubs, still hopes to win a title. The KCB player has been maintaining his fitness levels in Kiambu County, where he spoke to our reporter Joshua Makori.
With the Kenyan Premier League out of action due to the coronavirus pandemic, players such as Dennis Odhiambo have to ensure they remain fit. Odhiambo trains at Ruiru Sports Academy in Kiambu County.
Yeah, kuna zile session mimi hujiwekea na kuja hapa session za 1 hour, nafanya mazoezi na rudi kwa nyumba. Na bado kuna program si ufanya ya KCB. So kisha amka asubuhi nifanye program ya team, ya kunaendelea na yangu kidogo alafu narudi natulia.
Odhiambo plays for KCB, who finished the 5th place last season.
Tumekuwa tukiperform poa before COVID-19 ikuja, tulikuwa the right path, so nadhani tulikuwa tunaendelea kufanya vizuri. Target ilikuwa bado ni kushinda league, so nadhani tulikuwa tumeimprove. Tulikuwa so far tunaendelea vizuri.
The 35 years old has also played for Sofapaka and Thika United. He dreams of winning Kenyan Premier League title before he retires.
Yeah, kucheza ball lazima uko na achieve kitu, si kucheza tu ball na kuenjoy. Lazima uko na kitu ukiweza kuwa chini siku moja kabla umestaafu unajivunia. KCB tukiweza kufanya vizuri, labda season inakuja tukiweza achieve itakuwa ni vizuri sana, nitafurahia sana.
Odhiambo also played for the University of Pretoria in South Africa for 3 years.
Maisha ilikuwa si rahisi huko nje. Si rahisi, ni ngumu kwa sababu unaenda huko unacheza, unaenda kuadapt another culture, another lifestyle. Ikuwa rahisi nikianzilia, lakini ya kuja nikaadapt ikakuwa iko tu sawa.
Dennis Odhiambo has scored 3 goals in more than 40 appearances for Harambee Stars. His last major assignment with the national team was the 2019 Africa Cup of Nations in Cairo.
Yeah, ilikuwa good experience kucheza AFCON. Nadhani hiyo ndio top, I believe in the top competition in the continent. Wabi kutuendea vizuri. Kama vile kwa tunataka at least to advance to the next round. But experience ni tulipata huko at least kutoka na win. Kwa good kwa wachezaji nyumbani bado, as a nation ama wachezaji nyumbani bado watakuwa wakicheza hiyo AFCON. kuna qualify na tuna potential kubwa sana ya wachezaji ya kuweza kumake hiyo consistency ya kuweza qualify several times.
Odhiambo, who is also a farmer, has a piece of advice to young players.
Discipline ni key on and off the field. Lazima kuwe kwa discipline kwa Kenya unafanya. Unajua wewe unajua body yako, unajua job yako. Yeah, so unajua kucheza ball, kuna zile vitu unahitaji kufanya. Na kama mmoja wapo ni kuweza kufanya mazoezi. Yeah, kukaa vizuri, lifestyle mzuri. Right or
left, you can shoot. Now, former international football star Didier Drogba officially submitted his candidacy for the presidency of the Ivorian Football Federation, that's FIF, in Abidjan, promising to contribute to the, quote, rebirth of Ivorian football, which he said is not going well. Drogba drew a large crowd on Saturday, eager to watch him submit his candidacy before the deadline for next month's elections. The 42-year-old former African Footballer of the Year is one of four candidates seeking the presidency of the West African Countries Football Association. On top of needing nominations from three of the 14 League One clubs and two from the lower divisions, Drogba must have the endorsement of any of five special interest groups: coaches, doctors, current and former players, and referees. Now, Mikel Arteta hopes that Pierre-Emerick will stay at Arsenal to lead the Gunners to more success after scoring twice to beat Chelsea 2-1 in the FA Cup final on Saturday. Arsenal's captain dropped the trophy before lifting his first piece of silverware since moving to English football. Which interpreter tonight has been Flora Atieno. We will see you again tomorrow.
This is NTV. I help women find independence by training them in fish farming. It's tough on my back, joints, and can cause headaches. Panadol Extra relieves multiple types of pain. If symptoms persist, seek medical advice.
Pata 50% extra credo bila expiry. Ya kupiga na ku SMS across networks. Piga *444* scratch card pin hash. Na kama ni M-Pesa *444*2#. Safaricom for you.
In this house, my money is ours. But pesa yako, ya familia yako.
Various institutions have reported over 800 million units of unclaimed shares among other assets. To find out if you are an owner or beneficiary, dial *361# or visit www.ufaa.go.ke.
Finding the truth in these uncertain times has become certain. Possibilities for business even more convenient with the Nation e-paper. To enjoy this and more, simply dial *550*1# for daily Nation and *550*5# for business daily on your mobile phone and get 50% discount on the e-paper. Yes, for just 20 shillings each, the truth will find you and more possibilities right where you are. Dial *550*1# for daily Nation and *550*5# for business daily today. Terms and conditions apply.
I expected more from you, David.
Well, ma'am, I'm not disrespecting you.
I devoted myself looking out for you and your children, and do I get any gratitude? Of course not. She always gets the credit.
Marta worked hard to earn their love and affection. It's hard work, but you may want to try it.
That woman is very dangerous. And she's doing something to entrap my son-in-law, so I don't care how you do it. But I want every moment of that scheming woman's life to become a nightmare.
What can I do for you?
For me? Nothing really. I just came to inform you that I don't approve of someone like you. Even if you keep flirting with my father, never will you replace my mother.
Along came love. In association with Blue Band Peanut Butter.
NTV, turning on your world. The following program has been rated PG. It may contain scenes unsuitable for children under the age of 10.